Oh, no.
But that is exactly what's coming up right now. An early instalment of the volcano, Kano.
Yeah, just got to get the people up. Because I heard Damo on the radio yesterday say very likely that the pre-finals bye will be scrapped. It should be scrapped forever. So there's two things that we never need to see again following this season. One's the stand rule. Got to go. Don't want to see it again. The second is the pre-finals bye. The advantage that it doesn't give the teams that finish top four, particularly this year if they don't get that home ground advantage, what's the incentive to finish top four? So scrap the bye. Have it in the lead up to the grand final. Celebrate it. Get the teams fresh and ready to go for a big grand final. We don't need the bye before the finals start, and I hope we never, ever see it again.
What about during the finals, Kane? Because I know Damo's going to talk about this at length.
Well, I'm OK with one prior to the grand final, similar to what they do in the Super Bowl. You can have all the award season. Then you can get, you know, if a player's got a concussion, he may be able to come back and get the best availability for the grand final. But we don't need it in the lead up to the finals. And Port Adelaide and teams that are flying into the finals, it just sets it up beautifully for them.
Damo, what's the... It would be worse to actually have the bye before the grand final. It's going to be a very long 2 weeks.
Look, TJ, it's on the discussion list of topics, and it got really strong as the week rolled in. So the date of the grand final is September 25, Saturday, September 25. The best I can ascertain these conversations to be, that will stay. Again, things can change. We need to say that every single time we talk about COVID possibilities. But except if we work backwards from that, there's a thought, and there's two thoughts on this, whether you get the first 2 weeks of finals away or even the first 3 weeks of finals away without the bye, coming straight in off the round 23 season, and then to reset. So if it's to reset after the second week, after the semi-finals, there's four teams left. They may be then deciding getting all four teams into the one area they want to play the grand final, be it Melbourne, be it Perth, be it Adelaide, or to then play the prelim finals and just have two teams left and then have the reset to get into that potential state and that situation. So that's the way those conversations were going during the course of this week. And as we now have three matches remaining of round 22 and a full rack of round 23 still to come, that's where it's at.
Dave, I want to ask you, so at the moment Geelong are on top. Yep. So first week of the final, Port Adelaide a second. Will they get to play the finals in their state? So is it about money and getting it to a venue where we can get fans, or integrity of where they finish?
The money has to come into it, at least in the conversation since Lotto. The competition has been draining $5 million a week now for the best part of 12 weeks. That was on budgetary figures, given the requirements now to relocate so many people and to play games. So that's part of the conversation. In terms of the first week, again, these conversations during the week would have the first week of finals played where they're meant to be played. Now, that would be in front of no crowds in Melbourne, if that was the case.
And it would have to be Cordinia Park, surely.
Well, again, that conversation will start again.
But Port Adelaide would get a home final.
That's my understanding, Brad. But just to use the current quarantining allowances to get the first week away.
But, Damo, if Port Adelaide was to be given a home final, as Port Adelaide should, and there are no crowds in Melbourne, then Geelong has to play at Cordinia Park.
I would think so, TJ, given that scenario, given they've earned the right for the home final in that state. But, again, we have to say this again. That was the conversation as of Friday night, Saturday morning. Mm. Again, it could change. It could all change again. But I still feel it could be the prelim final, having that week off to get the two grand final teams potentially into WA, potentially elsewhere, or just to potentially reset Melbourne for the possibility
Just on that, I should reference to Melbourne win today, they'll go back to the top of the ladder. And how's their fans going if they don't get to see their club in the first week of the finals as well?
Yeah.